Now let's talk together about the difference between strategy and style. It's important to realize that there is a difference here. Remember, we've got adversarial negotiation on the one hand as a strategy, and we've got problem solving on the other. But you can see that you could be very easily confused about whether or not somebody is an adversarial, depending upon the voice tone and the style the person was adopting. So a style choice can often be thought of according to a range of competitiveness and cooperativeness. And let's look at how those may play out. You know, one of the most troubling experiences that I had a number of years ago was to work with a group of black South Africans who were coming to the United States. And they came to the United States and they were here presumably to learn executive skills for success back in South Africa. It was part of a State Department project to try to make sure that they were getting the help and advice that they needed and the education they needed to do good kinds of work in South Africa where they're growing businesses. And they came up to me in one of these negotiation programs and they described the following scenario. They said, we sat down with a group from the West and we told them about our business, our family business, and they said, we want you to succeed so much. We want you to really grow and to blossom, and we want to help you in all ways. Tell us about your business. And so we did. We told them about our market. We told them about the problems we were having with supplies. And lo and behold, this group from the West went away. They came back 6 months, and they set up a competing business. You see, while they appeared to be cooperative and problem-solving and interested in shared needs and goals, they were not negotiating in good faith. They were there really just to get information, and their strategy was adversarial. It was competitive. And their style looked cooperative, but the strategy was adversarial. And so, folks, please realize that the problem-solving strategy has some risks associated with it. The question is, do you have enough trust? Do you have enough of an understanding that the person on the other side is really there in good faith? If they're not there in good faith, then the risks of a problem-solving negotiation, the risks of a cooperative approach, appearance, can trick you into giving information that can be turned against you and used against you. And that may be, in fact, human nature at some point, that we all risk that kind of move between each other when we move from problem solving and competitive. But the style cannot be confused with the strategy. And part of what you're doing is trying to find out what authentically is the strategy that's being employed. And I'll give you another example to put it on the other side. For example, you could be extremely competitive and aggressive in your style. There's a fellow from New Jersey I'll never forget I met who came up to me. He's a plaintiff's personal injury lawyer and was really very, very confident that he could negotiate the best deal for a used car. He was the family used car dealer, and he described his technique this way. He would put on a t-shirt that said, "That's Mr. Asshole to you." It was a black t-shirt with white lettering. "That's Mr. Asshole to you." And he'd go into the car dealer's office and he'd say the following, "Look, I want to spend as little time with you as I possibly can. I'm going to be here for 15 minutes and we're going to do a deal and it's going to be take it or leave it. The deal is this: you prove to me what the cost is of that car," the one that he had pointed out, "and you prove to me what that car's price is, and I'll pay you $400 over your real costs for 15 minutes of work. But you have to agree to me that you will prove by invoice what your costs have been and what you've paid for that car, and I'll give you $400 on top. Take it or leave it." Now, what he says is that what that does is it provokes either a yes, I'll do it on those terms, or I won't. And what it does is it gives him an ability to go ahead and cut through all of the dancing that's going to go on. The need that's served with that is a need of time and management of time. He recognizes the need for a fair price over and above, and $400 he estimates is a pretty good price over for 15 minutes of work. And so on that strategy, he is a problem solver. He is analyzing underlying needs that they both have and thinking about that as a foundation for now getting over the top. His style with that t-shirt is a pretty aggressive style. It's competitive in its nature and tone. To some extent, you can think of any kind of brochure negotiation, which is a little room for give and take, but it's a demand, take it or leave it, as having some of those features. And the idea is that you have understood and analyzed going in what the true needs are of the parties so that you can get to problem solving much more quickly to address the issue. Now, what are the risks of these styles and strategy combinations? Well, you might imagine. The risks are, as you saw with the South Africans, the risks are that, in fact, you give the business away because the other side's not there in good faith. If you combine up a competitive style with an adversarial approach, strategy, what you have is high risk and high reward. As a matter of overall social science, if you adopt that combination, you sometimes settle high and get great deals, but often you deadlock. And as a net, in terms of your time, generally speaking, you come out where you would if you adopted a different style or strategy. In fact, social science tells us that the style strategy issues in combinations do not seem to create a difference in bargaining results on a zero-sum game measure. What we have instead is an insight into the risks of these combinations and a realization that you can pick the style and strategy combination that's right both for you and for the situation. So my suggestion to you is that you say to yourself, how am I when I am in a competitive mode? And how am I in a cooperative mode? And how do I want to combine those style issues with strategy choices that I'm making to be able to craft the best result I can for the client?